Am I still pretty? Am I?
A little bit.
This will do. Hey, Mishki, it's me, Coco Bechamel. Today, we'll make another Polish dish. Hunter stew, or bigos. Try saying it out loud. See? This one was really easy, and cooking bigos is about as easy as saying it. Hunter stew is a traditional Polish dish, but it's also very popular in Belarus, Lithuania, and Ukraine. The main ingredients are sauerkraut and meat. In case you don't like sauerkraut, don't turn this off yet. I promise it will taste completely different when we're done with it. Before we start, I do few things slightly less traditionally, but it's only to make it even better. Also, despite being rather heavy, this dish is actually keto-friendly. I have friends coming over tomorrow, and since they're on keto, I decided to kill two birds with one stone. The trick is to use very small birds and a big stone. Anyway, the portion we're making today will serve 3 people if you serve it with bread, pasta or potatoes, or about 2 people if they're going keto. Time for a personal fact. I don't own a big enough pot, so I'm actually making 2 batches of bigos today. You will only see one, for obvious reasons. But I don't want my friends, hi Sean and Derek, to be hungry. Let's cook! We'll use 1-quart jar of store-bought sauerkraut. Yes, it is better if you make it at home, but let's face it, who has the time? Start by draining your sauerkraut from the pickling water. Don't get rid of the water yet. You might need it later if your bigos isn't sour enough. Rinse sauerkraut in cold water and let it drain. Time for the meat. You can use whatever you want. In this video, we'll use pork, sausage and chicken. Hunter stew is perfect if you want to clean up your freezer. The acidity of sauerkraut will make any meat soft and tender. Cut your meat into reasonably sized pieces. This is the one time when the size of your meat doesn't matter. We will also need some fresh veggies. Anything other than fresh cabbage is optional, but believe me, the finished product is worth the extra work. Slice up some mushrooms. My mom always used dried mushrooms, so if you have those, go for it. Then slice half of an onion. Just slice, no need to dice it. It will dissolve in the final product anyway. Now the very important ingredient, fresh cabbage. I've used less than a half for now. When cooking bigos, fresh cabbage and sauerkraut water are the 2 things to use to balance the sourness. If it's too sour, add more cabbage. If it's too sweet, add more sauerkraut water. I just slice it quite thickly and then cut the slices into 3 smaller parts. There are different kinds of sauerkraut available in the stores. The one I got this time didn't have carrot inside, so I'm adding a little bit myself. Just a couple of inches of medium-sized carrot will do. No cutting, just grated. This is probably more than enough. To be more efficient, we're going to use a pot and a pan at the same time. If you worry that you work too slow, you can prepare everything first and then start cooking the sauerkraut. Put around a teaspoon of butter into a big pot and throw in your sauerkraut. She'll be alone for now, but she's a big girl, she's fine. Now take a pan and start frying all the other ingredients. I started with sausage. By the way, we don't season the sausage, but we do add salt and pepper to pork and chicken. We'll give it a touch of color, but we don't need to cook it fully. And here's the thing I do differently. Most people don't cook veggies separately. They just throw everything into the pot and call it a day. But the same people say Hunter stew needs to be burned to be good. Which is a lie. Burnt Hunter stew gets bitter and is terrible. Don't trust those lazy. We'll get our browning happen right now and in a controlled way, so we won't have to bother later. I used a medium-sized pan, so I started with just mushrooms and onions. Some salt and pepper, and let it cook. It reduces after a while, making enough room for the fresh cabbage. Now, just keep it cooking and add oil if it looks dry. Also, no butter. We want to be sure the browning comes from veggies, not burnt butter. This looks about done. Give it a stir and add some water. Just like when we make goulash, we want all the delicious browning to come off the pan. Transfer it all to the big pot. As you can see, sauerkraut already changed its color a little bit, and it will change even more drastically while cooking. Time for the carrot and some herbs / spices. Bay leaves, allspice, nutmeg, a tiny hint of cumin, and decent amounts of smoked paprika. Shout out to Mr. Bechamel, I forgot about tomato paste. 2 teaspoons will do the trick. Now add around half a cup of water and stir it well. And now, cook. I don't know how long it took you to cook other ingredients before adding them to the pot, but sauerkraut itself should be cooking for at least an hour on a medium or small heat. It is crucial to mix your Hunter stew at least once every 15 minutes, if you've never done it before, maybe even more often than that. It's impossible to make this dish taste bad in any other way than by burning it. The whole stew will turn bitter, your day will turn bitter, all your dreams will turn bitter, and you'll never be happy again! If you think I'm being dramatic, thank you. And this is how it looks after a full hour of cooking. Color is completely different, and as you can see, we lost a big chunk of volume. Picos reduces while cooking, so keep that in mind. Our cabbage gold is ready to be served. Traditionally, picos is served with bread or pasta. Some people even serve it as a side with their pork chops. Let's try it! Today, just a little bit, I want to save most of it for my friends. Oh my god, maybe a tiny bit more than a little bit, just in case. Everything is so soft and tender and sauerkrauty a little bit. Oh, I almost forgot. I made this batch for my friends who are on keto. I know. But usually you may add some extra sweetness, like honey or dried plums. I didn't because, you know, I respect their dumb diet. But you can do whatever you want. Well, that was fun. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something new. Remember to like, subscribe, and maybe even leave a lovely comment below. Also, feel free to check my other social media like Instagram and Facebook. Last but not least, you can tip me on Venmo. I just love money. Popatki!